Assalamualaikum and salam sejahtera to everyone. Now let's discuss SPM format question, which is solving problem involving integration. Okay, this is standard SPM format question. Let's discuss the example question straight away. Okay, diagram 10 show the curve y equals to x squared minus 16. It is given already. And the straight line ST, which is the tangent to the curve at point H. The gradient of straight line ST is negative 4. So that means gradient of tangent equals to negative 4. Okay, question A, find the coordinates of H. Okay, find the coordinate of H. And then what do? We know, okay, the gradient of the tangent equals to negative 4, okay, as well as equals to dy dx. Okay, so this question involving differentiation. So what do? Okay, and then we know that y equals to x squared minus 16, and differentiate dy dx equals to 2x. And then you know dy dx equals to gradient of tangent, and gradient tangent is negative 4. Therefore, the value of coordinate x equals to negative 4. Okay, we bring number 2 to the right hand side, it become division. Okay, it become division. So negative 4 divided by 2 equals to negative 2. And then substitute the value of x equals to negative 2 into equation y. So y equals to x equals to negative 2 squared minus 16 equals to 4 minus 16 equals to negative 12. Therefore, coordinate h equals to negative 2, negative 12. Okay, so is it logic? So it is under the x-axis. So the coordinate is negative 2, okay, negative 2, negative 12. Okay, so logic, okay. So this is negative 2, okay, negative 2. This is negative 5, right? And then this is question A. Okay, please write it down. And then straight away, question B, calculate the area of the shaded region. Okay, so this is the area of shaded region we want to find. Okay, so question B. Okay, so what do? We must know what is the value of the x-axis equals to 0. And then what do? We know y equals to x squared minus 16. And then when y equals to 0, so we get x squared minus 16 equals to 0. So x squared equals to 16, and x equals to plus minus square root 16 equals to plus minus 4 equals to negative 4 and 4. So that means from the diagram, we know this is the value of x equals to negative 4, and here positive 4. Okay, and then therefore, okay, the area, if you look here, okay, the area is we must plan nicely. Okay, this is S to T is a straight line. Okay, so we can find the area of straight line. Area of triangle. Right? Okay. So here is 0, and this is 5. Okay, negative 5. So the length of S 0 is 5 unit, and the height. Okay, the height of H here. Okay, not T, but H here is negative 12. So 12. Therefore, okay, the idea to find the area of the shaded region, okay, equals to the triangle, right? This is the triangle, okay, this is the triangle, minus, okay, this is the triangle, minus with, okay, minus with the area of under curve, okay, under curve, which is, we can say it, area of under curve, the shaded orange color. Okay, so how to find the shaded orange color area? So equals to modulus integrate for the value of AB y dx. Okay, and then modulus. Why we put modulus? Because okay, the area of the both shaded region, okay, the orange especially is under the x-axis, so it must be negative. Okay, so how to rearrange or arrange the formula? So area of triangle equals to 1 over 2 times 5, okay, the base, and times height 12, minus, okay, so the limits of the under curve is for this one, okay, is negative 2 to negative 4. So negative 2 and negative 4. Y is x squared minus 16 dx, and don't forget to put modulus, and then simplify. Okay, and then work out. Okay, equals to 6. So equals to 6 equals to 30. Sorry. Okay. This is not 5. Right. My bad. Okay. So the area of the triangle is negative 2 to 5. Okay. Sorry. My bad. Okay. So actually equals to negative 5 plus minus negative 2 equals to 3. Okay. negative 2 minus negative 5. So you get 3. So 3 times 6 equals to 18, right? So again, so how do I get 3? Okay, so negative 2 minus negative 5. Okay, for the length of the x-axis. Okay, then minus integrate x squared minus 16. So we get x power of 3 over 3 minus 16x for the limits, and negative 2 negative negative 4, and then work out. So 18 minus bracket negative 2 power of 3 over 3 minus 16 times negative 2, and then okay, this is for the limit 2, and then minus for limit 4 minus bracket negative 4 power of 3 over 3 minus 16 times negative 4 bracket, okay, sorry, okay, big bracket, and then so using your calculator, 18 minus, so we'll get I forget to write down the modulus equals to negative 8 over 3 plus 32, okay, and then minus bracket negative 64 over 3 plus 64 modulus, and then equals to 18 minus modulus 88 over 3 minus negative 128, sorry, over 3 modulus. So you get 18 minus negative 40 over 3, and then the answer 18 minus modulus 40 over 3 equals to the final answer equals to 14 over 3 unit squared. Okay, unit squared. Okay, and then let's continue with question C. Okay, so question C, the question asks you, when the region bounded by the curve x-axis and straight line y equals to p, okay, this is p, rotated through 360 about the y-axis, the volume of revolution is 110 pi unit cubic. Find the value of p. Okay, from here, okay, let's discuss. Okay, so you know this is y equals to x squared minus 16. Okay, so the volume rotated about the y-axis is equals to pi. Okay, and then AB x squared dy. So the equation of x actually equals to, okay, so now x squared equals to y plus 16, and then substitute into, okay, into the formula, and then okay, the limit is 0 to p. So 0 p, and x squared, the value of x squared, we already get a value of x squared, so become y plus 16 dy. Okay, this is how we substitute into the formula, and the volume equals to 110 pi unit cubic, and then work out, right, pi, okay, and then integrate y squared over 2 plus 16y, okay, for the limits of 0 p equals to 110 pi, and then we can simplify the pi, the value of pi, and then substitute the limits 0 and p, so we get for the first limit, 0 squared over 2 plus 16 times 0, okay, and then minus, okay, for p, so p squared over 2 plus 16 p equals to 110, and then simplify, so we get negative p squared over 2 plus 16 p, bring 110 to the left hand side, minus 110 equals to 0. So because of the terms squared is negative, so how about if we multiply all the equation with negative 2, and then we get p squared, positive p squared plus 32 p minus minus 32 this is minus, okay, minus, okay, so okay, when you expand the negative, so minus, so plus 32 p plus 120 equals to 0. Alright, and then by using your calculator, you check using apps in your calculator and find the value of p, so you will get p equals to negative 10 and p equals to negative 22. Okay, and then okay, don't forget to fill in the bracket, so p plus 10 and p plus 22. Okay, because if you look here, okay, so if this is y equals to x squared, y equals to x squared minus 16, so the y-intercept of the curve is negative 16. Okay, so negative 16. Okay, therefore, okay, because of p greater than negative 16, Okay, you look here. P is above the negative 16. So, therefore, our conclusion, P equals to negative 10. Okay, so that's why P equals to negative 10 above the negative 16. Okay, so this is a type of SPM format question, one of the type of question. And I hope, okay, for integration, okay, it find at the area as well as the volume. So I hope you can understand at least until now. Thank you.